Okay, what we learned yesterday is how to draw a graph for a given pair of linear equations and solve them using the graph. Sometimes the linear equation, the graph of the linear equation, set of linear equations given, the two lines may be intersecting or may fall one over the other, or they may be parallel to each other. So those cases we study using a screen share now. Now I can go for a screen share. Are you all able to see my desktop screen here?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now let us see the once again what are the different conditions we have got here yesterday. So using GeoGebra, I am going to demonstrate again the lines, different lines and conditions. Okay, this is only explanation, then we will go for the correct writing part of the notes. Yesterday this is what we have seen, this is what we have seen yesterday. Okay, now I will change the equations here. Change the equation 2x plus 4y plus 1 equal to 0, then minus x plus 2y plus 5 equal to 0 are the equations. Let us say equation 1 is 2x plus 4y plus 1 equal to 0, minus x plus 2y plus 5 equal to 0 is the second equation. Now observe the ratios here, children. Ratio of coefficients of x, coefficients of y and the constant terms here. Coefficients of x, 2 by minus 1, that means it is minus 2 here. Here this is 4 by 2 or it is just 2. This is minus 2, this is plus 2. Are they equal? No. Monica Reddy, are they equal? Minus 2 and 2 are not equal, no?
Sir.
They are not equal. Therefore, when the lines are intersect, here we are getting the two ratios of ratio of coefficients of x, coefficients of the other variable y, the ratios are not equal. That means a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. We stop there. Suppose these two are equal, what will happen? Let us see. Suppose these two are equal, that means I want to put it as 1 here. Now here this is 2 by 1 and this is 4 by 2, that is also 2. This is 2, this is also 2. And I want to make 2 here, 1, 2 and 0, minus 1, 0.5 is not possible. So I will make it 2 here and 1 here. Now you see the ratios a1 by a2 is 2 by 1, meaning 2, 2 by 1 is 2. B1 by B2, that is 4 by 2, that is also 2. C1 by C2, 2 by 1, that is also 2. All three ratios are equal. In the first case, what we have seen, A1 by A2 not equal to B1 by B2, we have checked. Then, we have a solution for that, they are intersecting lines. Now, these two ratios, first two ratios are equal, then we are going to check whether they are equal to the third ratio or not. All three ratios are equal. Therefore, the lines are falling one over the other. They are a pair of coincident lines. Coincident lines. Lines falling one over the other. Lokesh Pawan, are you following? Lokesh? Lokesh?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Good, good. Are you able to see the presentation on the screen? Yes.
Right. Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, let us see if A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. In that case, we will see. Now, here you see, this is 1 by 2 by 1, that is 2. This is also 2, but it is 1 by 2 here. That means, A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. The third ratio is not equal to the first two ratios. In that case, the lines are parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. If there are two parallel lines, If they don't intersect at all, we say that the system of equations or the pair of equations has no solution. No solution. So, if the lines are parallel, then we say the pair of equations has no solution. If the pair has, say for example, if they are intersecting like this, then we say they have a solution. If the solution can be seen, you see A minus 1 minus 1 is the solution. Okay, next, if the system can be, like, see, so many lines are formed. A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2 in all these cases. Therefore, the lines are intersecting. So, for the lines to intersect, lines are intersecting meaning the ratios of x coefficients by and the ratio of y coefficient, these two are not equal. We can see the solution for these. Whereas, if the ratios are equal, in that case, if the ratios are equal, in that case, if the ratios are equal and 4 by 1, I want to put all 4 by 1s, I will put here. Let us see, then if this also is 4 by 1, you can see how the line is coming and joining here. Is the blue line coming and joining with the red line? Could you see the demonstration?
Yes,
the line, blue line,
yes,
joining the red line.
Yes, sir.
Meaning, all the three ratios are equal here, you can see. Okay, 4 by 1, 4 by 1, 4 by 1. Therefore, the lines coincident, the lines join, fall one over the other. They are called coincident lines. And in such cases, the pair of linear equations have many solutions. It is as good as one particular linear equation in two variables. One equation in two variables will have infinitely many solutions, right? Therefore, we have many solutions for these two equations. Next, if A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 and not equal to C1 by C2, in that case, the lines are parallel, they are apart, we cannot solve them. Now here, I will stop this screen and open another one for you. So we will see all these in a particular notes form. In the form of a notes, we will check all this. This is in Microsoft Word I am opening. I will send you in the form of PDF so that you can all write these notes today in your classwork notebook. See, pair of linear equations in two variables. Pair of linear equations in two variables. Now, two linear equations in the same two variables are called a pair of linear equations in two variables. The most general form of the linear equations of a pair of linear equations is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, where a1, a2, b1, b2, c1, c2 are real numbers. And there is another condition that a1 square plus b1 square should not be equal to 0, a2 square plus b2 square should not be equal to 0. Of course, condition, you need not worry about the condition. So, this is what we have learned so far in this one. So, could you highlight, I highlighted the lines here for you. Two linear equations in two variables, in the same two variables, are called a pair of linear equations. General form is given here. Right? Next, we will have pair of linear equations. How many solutions, how to solve the equations? There are two methods. One, graphical method. One is the graphical method. Why is it not coming from the beginning? Okay. Now I will check this again. One is the graphical method. One is the graphical method here. You can see. Oh, it is only starting from L. Graphical method, and another is the algebraic method here. So, all the graphical method already we have checked. We have already checked the graphical method, how to draw the graph of the equation here. Now, on comparing the ratios A1 by A2, B1 by B2, and C1 by C2, we can state the following conditions. First condition, if A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the graphical representation is intersecting lines, and such pair of linear equations will have unique solution. What do we say that? Unique solution. Lakshmikant, repeat. Lakshmikant,
unique.
Unique.
Sir.
Unique means one and only one. Only one solution such pair will have. Next.
Sir.
Ah, right. Very good, Lakshmikant. Now come back. Now A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 and is also equal to C1 by C2. Then the lines are coincident and there will be infinitely many solutions. If A1 by A2 and B1 by B2 are equal, but that is not equal to C1 by C2, in that case, the lines are parallel lines and we don't have any solution for such lines, for such set of equations. Now, how to find, suppose two equations are given and each time will you draw the graph and find this? Not required. You can simply check the condition by checking the ratios of ratios A1 by A2, B1 by A2, C1 by C2 we take first. We take the ratios A1 by A2, B1 by A2, C1 by C2 first. If the first two ratios A1 by A2 and B1 by A2 are not equal, we immediately say the graph is intersecting lines, it has unique solution. The pair has unique solution, simply. In that case, we say the pair is consistent. What is that called? Consistent. The pair is called a pair of consistent equations. Then, next also we call when A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, if that is the ratio is also equal to the third one, in that case also the pair of equations we call consistent pair. Suppose first two pairs are equal and that is not equal to the third pair, then we say the pair is inconsistent. What do we call it? Inconsistent pair of linear equations. Could you see the markings here? So these are the three conditions. You have to, you can take a screenshot if you want. These conditions, this tabular form today you write on a piece of paper, stick it in your study room or elsewhere. For 3 days you continuously read every morning. As soon as you get up, read these conditions, by heart them. So that by Monday when I ask you, you should be able to tell without seeing. Will you all do that? Gautam, tell me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Very good.
Sir.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
That's nice. That's nice. Now we'll go for algebraic methods of solving the equations. Okay, that we will do it at a later stage. Anyway, what are these equations? Let us see. What are these methods? One is substitution method. This method is also called as elimination by substitution. Next one is called elimination method. It involves equating the coefficients and eliminating them. And cross multiplication method is another method. This is also called direct method, but this method is now eliminated from the syllabus. Now it is not there in the syllabus. So first two methods we have to learn now in algebraic methods. Now several situations will come in day-to-day life problems, and those can be mathematically represented by two equations. Sometimes these equations are not linear but can be reduced to a pair of linear equations and then solved. Now let us practice some equations today. Now as you see the pairs here, I will give the answers also here only. We have four questions, practice questions here. First one. X plus 3y equal to 6, 2x minus 3y equal to 12. This you have to solve graphically. 2x minus 3y equal to 1, 3x minus 4y equal to 1. These are the questions for practice for solving graphically. So you have to do that. Second question is for those people, those who really want to learn something better and more, it is called Hart's question. It's called a Hart's question. Now you can see this Hart's question in yellow colored lining. A triangle is formed by the lines x plus 2y minus 3 equal to 0, 3x minus 2y plus 7 equal to 0, and y plus 1 equal to 0. Find graphically the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle and its area. Wonderful question. That means there are three lines involved here. For each equation you have to find two solutions minimum. Draw a line, and then all these three lines are drawn on the same graph sheet, you will get a triangle by intersection of these three lines. You have to name the coordinates as well as you have to find the area of this one. Third question also is graphically solving the equation. Then now fourth question we try here. These three questions I am giving you, all these questions in the homework, children, you have to practice them. Now fourth question I will make you a practice here only. Now what is the condition of the following system of equations? Okay, what is the condition means here? Consistency condition. With these three conditions are called consistency conditions. What are these conditions called? Consistency conditions. Consistency means whether we will be able to solve them or not. Okay, whether we will be able to solve a system of equations or not can be easily understood by checking the ratios. Now we will move on to the first question here. I am writing the answer for the first question. I'll take some page here. Now space I am giving. First one, x plus y equal to 5, x minus y equal to 3. Each equation you have to represent now as an equation in the standard form. Now, so how to represent this in a standard form? Very simple. X plus y minus 5 equal to 0. That is C I am bringing to the other side. Okay, 0. Next, here also I will give a space, so that it will be clear. Now the second equation also I will mark like this. Are you following my demonstration here, children, all of you?
Yes sir.
It is just like my whiteboard. As and when you see, immediately you keep writing in your notebook. That will be easy, is it not? X minus y, and this minus also I'll bring the 3 also this side, equal to 0. Here equal to 0 is not placed, I don't know why. Right, so these are the standard forms I wrote. Now what is the value of a1 here? A1 equal to 1, because coefficient of x is 1 there, and b1 equal to 1 again, and c1 equal to how much? Geeta, can you tell me?
Minus 5.
Right, now for the second equation also I am writing what is a1, what is a2, what is a3, what is a1, a2, b1, b2, c2. A2 equal to 1 again, b2 equal to minus 1 this time here, it is minus 1, and c2 equal to minus 3. Okay. Next, Kanishka, is that okay? Are you looking at the board? Right. Next one.
Sure.
Now, this is the second equation, children. Of course, oh, this zero has come here. Right. Now, second equation, first equation we brought. Now, what we do is, we are taking the ratios here. A1 by A2 I will take. Here, what is one equation I will take? And one for this one. A1 by A2. What is A1 by A2? That is equal to 1 by 1. Again, I will take one fraction form here. type out that 1 by 1. What is the value of 1 by 1? It is again 1. Ratio is 1, we say. Ratio is 1. Next, B1 by B2 I will take now. This time, I will take B1 by B2. What is B1 by B2 I will take here? I am copying this one. And this is B1 by B2. Of course, when we are writing, we write fast. But we are typing the fractions, it is not. It is difficult. 1 by minus 1 here. 1 by minus 1. Can you tell me what is the value of 1 by minus 1? 1 by minus 1, can anybody tell me?
Sir, 0, sir.
Hey, who is that? It is minus
1. 1.
Minus 1, minus 1. Because we are dividing a positive number by a negative number, you will get a negative number, negative result again here. So, 1 by 1 is 1. That is 1 by minus 1 is minus 1. Now, here you got already A1 by A2 is equal to 1, B1 by B2 equal to minus 1. Are these two equal now, these two ratios?
No,
these,
sir.
No, sir.
These two ratios are not equal. Therefore, we don't find the third ratio, not required. Directly we write here, A1 by A2, here we write here, A1 by A2 is not equal to, okay, not equal to B1 by B2. Not equal to B1 by B2. Therefore, what we can say? So, the pair of linear equations in two variables given, the given pair of linear equations in two variables, given pair of linear equations in two variables, tell me what is consistent, is consistent. Consistent. And if you take, see, this is the condition, you have to write all these conditions. Consistent, the graphical representation is intersecting lines, they will have a unique solution. Consistent, what you have to write here? You have to write all these, is consistent, oh, spelling is wrong, alright. Consistent, the graph is, graph,
intersecting lines.
Very good. The graph of this pair, graph is intersecting lines and
they have unique solution.
Very good. The pair has, you write, instead of writing they have, the pair has a unique solution. Did you understand how to write this one? So first, what we are doing, the steps here from the beginning, I will check, tell you this one. First, we write the equations in the standard form first. In the standard form, we write the equations. And then, after writing the equations in standard form, we take the ratios here, A1 by A2, B1 by B2. If the ratios are not equal, immediately we write, they are consistent, graph is intersecting lines, and the pair has a unique solution. Then, let us take the second case. Suppose they are equal, A1 by A2 equal to B1 B2. Then we also check the third ratio, whether they are equal or not. Let us see the second question here.